Welcome back. Well, while we were drinking flat whites, these guys were hard at work on a response time test. We first ran this test before the show. Then we gave them all coffee. Two of them got normal coffee and two had decaffeinated. They don't know which. Now we want to compare the results. Did caffeine affect how well they performed?
Come on down, Tony. How have they got on? What are the results?
Well, what we found, surprisingly enough, actually, was that the people who'd had the caffeine actually did speed up a little bit on that task, very slightly, and the people who'd had the decaffeinated coffee actually slowed down a small amount.
So caffeine does make us alert?
It does.
So how does it make us alert?
Well, the way it works is that it blocks a chemical in the brain. Now, this other chemical is involved in being sleepy or being wakeful, right? And this other chemical tends to make you sleepy. So when caffeine blocks that, what it tends to do is to prolong your period of wakefulness. So it stops you from becoming sleepy by blocking that other chemical.
So how long have we been doing this? How long have we been using caffeine as a stimulant?
Apparently caffeine was first discovered by an Ethiopian goat herd back in about 400 AD, and he noticed that his goats didn't fall asleep when they were eating the berries of the coffee tree.
Well, I'll go with that one. I like that. So caffeine is a drug? Is it a chemical?
Oh, it is a drug, yeah. It's a drug. It's the most commonly used psychoactive drug that there is. And by psychoactive, I've just mean a drug that's got some effect on psychological processes, something that affects your mood, something that affects your mental processes.
Is there a danger you can have too much?
As with anything, yes, there is a danger of having too much. I mean, excessive caffeine use has got... some bad side effects. I mean, the most obvious one is that it disturbs your sleep, makes you feel a bit jittery and on edge and perhaps a little bit anxious. And of course, if you do use a lot of caffeine and you stop using it, you get a bit of a rebound then you do feel very sleepy.
Hey, well, thanks, Tony. Yeah. And do stay around because we've got another test to look at the effects of caffeine on memory. So keep that coffee flowing, guys. Now, dinner parties can be fun, but what happens when you get the call just the day before to be told that one of the groups a freaking vegan? Well, I'd think about cancelling. Let's face it, that leg of lamb and chocolate mousse is well off the menu. So what can you cook? And what is a nut rissole anyway? Dean Cornish left his steak and cheese pie at home and went to find out what being a vegan means.
I've invited Caro, a committed vegan, to take a look around my meat lover's home. She went vegan 6 years ago for health reasons.
I was at my wit's ends. I had acne all over my chest, my face, my back. It was quite revolting. And I was on medication for it, and the doctor, I said, look, I'm sick of taking these drugs. And the doctor said, well, you've got no other option. You're going to be on the medication for life. And so I did a little bit of research and found out about a diet that didn't include animal products and it helped with skin. And yeah, and it was basically a vegan diet for 4 weeks. And I thought, well, after doing it for 4 weeks, I thought, if this can make me so healthy, then obviously I probably shouldn't be going back to having animal products.
What is veganism?
Veganism is avoiding animal products and anything that contributes towards animal cruelty. So a vegan is going to avoid anything in their diet that contains meat or dairy, things like cheese and yogurt. They're not going to wear any leather products.
OK, time to let Caro loose in my house, as I'm planning to road test a week of vegan living.
Now, there's obvious things that I'm not going to be able to get with, like this butter and cheese. Yeah. I've got the salad there, that's all right, but what else?
Yeah, there's a few other things that you probably want to clear out. Anchovies for a starter, fish sauce, shrimp paste. Let's have a look at the wine. They have to state in New Zealand whether it's clarified the traditional way, which they use animal products, including eggs, milk and fish. So if you can just check the back of your wine labels as well, it's a good way of avoiding animal products.
So the old fridge is clearly going to need a clean out there, Caro. Thanks for That's the advice, like though. What about the bathroom?
Okay, let's have a look. Yep, I can see...
There's no meat in there.
I can see a few things already that we want to avoid. One of the things that you want to start thinking about when you go vegan is it from a company that tests on animals?
There's a number of common toiletries that Caro says are off limits if you're a vegan because the parent companies either test products on animals or won't confirm or deny that they do. And that's not all.
Now, with this hair product here, it's got beeswax in it. So usually vegans try to avoid any products from insects, including bee products. So beeswax, we wouldn't use that.
So honey's out?
Honey's out,
right.
Yeah. Most vegans do avoid honey. And this one here, this has got milk and honey in it.
Does it actually have milk and honey in it?
I just assumed
with a lot of these things that they would just sort of say that to make you feel good, but no, you're right, they do. I've got the bedroom now. You can tell me a few of the things that might be non-vegan in here, I suppose.
Okay, well, the first place I'd stop at is probably the bed.
Yeah.
Can you tell me what sort of bedding you've got?
I've got the old goose down under there in the duvet and the goose down pillows as well.
Right,
very
okay.
Warm in winter, cool in summer.
Yeah, well, that's something that you probably want to avoid.
Kara says it's not just the feathers. She reckons some geese are live plucked.
I've also heard something about wool. Tell me about the old wool thing as far as the vegans go.
Yeah, wool is something that we're going to try and avoid as a vegan. It's not a nice life for those sheep, even though we're not killing them. They're still, they're shed twice a year. It's really quite scary for them being shorn. They're outside in the cold afterwards, so they're freezing. They don't give them any jackets. There's no proper housing for them or protection. They're taking away their babies. They're not able to interact.
They would never normal life here. They're from Arabia. It wouldn't exist here.
No, and it would be great if they weren't here, actually. Right. Unfortunately, we have 40 million sheep in New Zealand. Our biggest contributor to climate change is methane gas from farmed animals.
Well, the duvet's out, along with half the wardrobe, bathroom and fridge. Time to restock. So first the supermarket to find out what I can eat. Obviously, fruit, veggies and nuts will get the tick.
Meat. All that meat.
Here we've got a whole range of vegan products from Sanitarium.
Oh yeah.
So the nut meat is really, really nice. You can fry that up.
Nut meat?
Yeah. I love that. Love that one. Falafel?
Oh yeah.
Make those into little balls
and
you can fry them or bake them, yeah. And then things like hummus are really nice. It's a great way of getting your protein into you.
Yeah.
So if you're giving up the flesh, you'll need protein. Good vegan protein sources include tofu and soy products, and lentils, chickpeas and beans. There's loads of vegan-friendly soy sausages and veggie soups at the supermarket, along with some unexpected treats.
Most of the chips here do actually contain animal products. Most of them contain milk. Some of them may contain meat byproducts and things like that. Salt and vinegar is going to be safest bet at this stage. So these are the nicest ones. Sea salt and herb, they're the best ones that I've had.
Oh, okay. Chickpea chips.
Yeah, do you...
So not made of potatoes?
No, so they're high in protein as well.
Right. Crikey, you're just taking me down the naughty aisles.
Well, you can be naughty and be a vegan. It's nice to have treats, and there are certain biscuits here that don't contain animal ingredients. Crazy Faces, they are vegan.
Hobnobs?
Yep.
Right.
At the counter, I've found myself laden with a far greater variety and, yes, much healthier-looking shopping trolley than normal. But the real vegan holy grail is here at the Safe Shop, where about 1,000 regular vegan customers come to get everything from non-leather stuff called pleather to vegan cheese.
We've got blue.
Yep.
We've also got cheese that melts, so you can do your pizzas, mozzarella, cream cheese. There's a huge variety in here. It's fantastic. Wow.
Vegan bacon.
It even looks like bacon. It's absolutely delicious.
Vegan bacon.
There's a huge array of mock meats. Vegan chicken, vegan tuna, vegan lobster, vegan sausage.
How does it taste?
It tastes amazing. My mouth waters just thinking about that stuff.
Wow.
Well, we might have to see about that, as I feel a taste test coming on.
Thanks, Dean. Now, it'd be fair to say that veganism is still a bit fringe, yet vegetarians have loads of options. Most restaurants have a veggie dish, even if it is just a lasagna or a frittata. And the shops these days have loads of non-meat options. Some of them taste more like meat than the real thing. So after the break, we're taste testing mock meats.